There's only one parachute.
Oh no, what are we gonna do?
Well, I'm going to take it.
Wait, why?
Well, first thing first, I'm Canadian, so I'm very polite. I was the most important railway surveyor and construction engineer of the 19th century and a distinguished inventor and scientist. In 1848, I prepared maps of Peterborough, Hamilton, Cobourg, and Toronto. In 1851, I designed Canada's first postage stamp, which publicized the beaver as a distinctly Canadian emblem.
Psh, is that all?
In 1871, I became head engineer of the proposed Canadian Pacific Railway, and thanks to my innovations, most of my works will last centuries, and the primary benefits of this Canadian Pacific Railway is that it provides the means to ship vast quantities of merchandise freight, intermodal traffic, and bulk commodities across all of North America. In 1863, I was picked by the Canadian government to lead a study to connect Halifax to Vancouver. I also developed the National Highway, and once it was completed in 1855, it connected Eastern Canada to BC and played an important role in the development of the nation.
I don't know. I think the rest of us are pretty great, too, and equally deserving of this parachute.
Oh, yeah? Well, you're grotesquely incompetent at romance, and you managed to contract syphilis at a brothel while you were still in college. Your mustache is so bad, it scares away women.
Yeah, I have to agree with Sanford on this one. Ew. Well, okay, I bet you have nothing on me.
You invented jack shit. Your so-called research was stolen by a monk named Gregor Mendel in 1851. And don't get me started on you, Einstein. How the hell do you treat your wife? I shouldn't intrude, but who gives their wife a contract which says, and I quote, "You will renounce all personal relations with me insofar as they are not completely necessary for social reasons."
I don't want to talk about that.
Well, I had many theories regarding capitalism and communism and describing the exploitation of the working class.
Oh yeah? Well, you couldn't even get a job, and you indirectly killed more than 100 million people. Cause communism.
Scheiße, he knows.
I'm so hungry. Someone get me some food.
Oh, shut up, Nightingale. The only thing you're hungry for is fame, and that's the only reason you helped anyone. Isn't that true, you power-crazed freak?
Okay, but what else did you, like, do? You just built trains. That's boring.
Hey, Florence, what's the time?
Well, it's 3:47. Why?
You're reading the time thanks to me, Florence. I advocated the adoption of standard time, as well as established time zones. I established Greenwich, England, at a 0 degree longitude, as the standard time, and divided the world into 24 time zones. I was inspired by this after I missed a train to Ireland, actually. That day was shitty.
Well, I invented the light bulb, and I was a master of electricity.
Well, what you did was abuse your power. I mean, you were the first person to kill an elephant. The first! I'm worried you're the first. What the hell? Hey, Freud, you had some terrible theories. One of them being that lesbianism is always the fault of the father and is curable through psychoanalysis. Hey, Freud, your daughter is a lesbian.
She's what? Well, I created the rabies vaccine, which saved so many animals and people.
You didn't do it for the animals. You hate dogs, and that reason alone should be enough to let you die. And you, Lincoln, you didn't believe blacks should have the same rights as whites. What kind of backwards mentality is that? And speaking of backwards mentality, Mr. Yetsen, you're homophobic.
Well, you must have done something very wrong.
Well, internet says nothing about me, so I'm pleased. Leaping through the sky like a tiger.